Hello, Patrick Walchuk here with an update on the Ottawa real estate market to the end of May 2023. And if you enjoy getting these movies, hit the subscribe button and the notification bell and we'll get them pushed out to you every 30 days. So let's take a look at what went on in May, comparing it to May of last year. And in terms of residential properties that do not include condos, we had 917 homes trade hands, and that's an increase of almost 5%. Now, the average price is actually down. So in Ottawa, the average price is about $799,000, and that's a decline of about 6.5%. In terms of the number of listings on the market, the inventory levels are now at 2,542, which is an increase of 38%, which seems very huge, right? But I crunched these numbers, and this represents that there's about a 9.1-week supply of inventory on the market. So that says that this is still a very strong seller's market, because a balanced market is defined as basically having about 21 to 24-week supply. And again, this is only a little over 9 week supply, which makes the decline in prices very interesting, right? Because you have fewer properties for sale to have a balanced market, yet prices have declined. So in terms of how long it's taking to sell, they're selling in 18 days compared to 10 last year. And we'll move into the world of condominiums next. And they're about flat with sales last year of 430. The average price for a condo is now about $446,000. That's a decline of a little over 7%. The number of listings is up by about 14%. And in terms of how long these properties are on the market, it's taking 26 days for a condo to sell in Ottawa. Now, when we look at the month over month average sale prices of both freehold and condo across the city, for the first 4 months of the year, you can see that we are going up, 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 up. And for May, we're actually down about 1.5% compared to April. So it depends how you look at it. Well, this is how you look at it. So, however, if you look at May compared to January, prices are up on the year of over 14%. So we'll see what happens here. Is this really the dead cat bounce? And we're going to have another mini correction? We'll see.